I'll recognize the member for Timiskaming, Cochrane.
Thank you, Speaker. I wasn't expecting to be here today, but I am actually happy to be here today. Any time that I can spend time talking about animals and farmers and the problems they face, and that's what I'm going to focus on regarding this act. And my colleague from Brampton North covered a lot of the issues, and hopefully I'm not going to replow that ground. So the OSPCA has been a problem for a while in the agricultural sector, and mainly because it's a charitable organization doing the job of a police force. And this doesn't reflect badly on the people who work for the OSPCA. They are doing everything they can with what they have, but they face some incredible stressful situations. Because sometimes when animals are not treated well, it has to do with mental health issues of the owners. There's many issues. And to expect someone who works for a charitable organization to go in and deal with things like that, you're expecting a lot. And also, the training available to all the people across the province isn't the same. And that is a huge issue. And I'll give you a personal example. I have only dealt with the OSPCA once before I got elected. So we had a dairy farm. But across the road from our dairy farm, my wife had a store. And the OSPCA inspector came regularly to my wife's antique store. And one day, my wife's horse was beside our barn, lying flat out. And the OSPCA was across the road. And the inspector said, "Oh my God, there's a dead horse there. Someone isn't treating, you know, what's happening?" And my wife says, "Dead horse, but the horse is dead." And she ran to the, and she says, "Velvet." And the horse got up and walked over to the inspector, and a donkey came too, and they had a light. And it turned out very nicely. But that inspector, because she didn't deal, I guess, with a lot of horses, didn't know the difference between a dead horse and a live horse.
And one that's sleeping.
And it was a very well-treated horse. And that was truly frightening. Now, if that inspector had showed up on my farm door and said something like that, it might not have turned out that well. So it's something that needs to change. And I think an agriculture across the province welcomes the opportunity to make some changes and to bring the chief inspector under the government's purview is a step in the right direction, but it's a very tiny step, and it won't fix the system. Agricultural organizations have been doing their best. Many of them have signed memorandums of understanding with the OSPCA to work together with them, because many dairy, swine, beef, they have their own animal treatment protocols. So I know as a dairy farmer, we had regular inspections to make sure our animals were treated correctly. And you know what? As farmers want to make sure all the animals are treated correctly. And if farmers find out that someone isn't doing the job correctly, they will point them out, as happened in Stouffville. No one in the farm community who's doing things right wants someone else. Farmers love animals. They don't want other people to mistreat animals. So let's make that really, really, really clear. So this is a very small first step, and farmers will work lockstep with the government, and so will the official opposition, to try and make this system better, to try and make this system that that the inspectors are trained to the same level, that they're equipped to deal with some very stressful situations, that actually make this work. I'm not sure in the long term that this can continue to be an OSPCA situation. These people need to be trained, and they need to know that a farmer in Oxford County or a farmer in Earlton has the same level of training when that person knocks on the door. And that is not the case now. It's not the case. There are places now in this province where there is no training, where there is no people. And I'm not going to blame this on this government or the previous government. That's just what happened. And we've got to fix that. And We're willing to fix it, and I hope the government is actually sincere with they've taken a preliminary step saying it's an interim step for the appointment of the chief inspector. I hope, Speaker, that they're sincere that this is a small preliminary step and they're actually going to work towards fixing the problem. There are some red flags, because on many other issues the government has provided less funding instead of more funding. And quite frankly, to do this right, Speaker, it's going to cost money. And the government has to make a decision. Is it worth doing right, or is it worth risking animal welfare and, at times, risking people? And the government has to make that decision. And if they make the decision that it's not worth it, we're going to come after them. But if they make the decision that it is worth it and it's worth doing right, we're going to work with them, and so will farmers. This also provides a unique opportunity, Speaker, because animal welfare is a very emotional issue, and people have different values regarding animal welfare. Some people are very opposed to the use of animals at all. We respect that view. We respect people that have that view and who want to forward that view. The issue is, on occasion, some people with that view break into farms and violate farmer families' personal space. On occasion, it's happened here, they remove, at that point it was a dead animal, remove an animal, totally destroying biosecurity. That is not acceptable. And that we also have to work together to make sure that people understand the ramifications and that farm families aren't violated. Farm families are expected to treat their animals correctly, and that's why we need a very strong welfare system. But on the flip side, Speaker, farm families also have to know that they are going to be protected by the laws of the province. And there are times when they don't feel like that, Speaker. And again, this is going to cost money. Let's make this clear. If you've got a court backlog and someone gets charged for doing something on a farm and that case gets thrown out because there's, quite frankly, we've got more important cases, well, when that farm family feels violated and those court cases get thrown out and you've got so much emotions, because that farm family is going to be emotional, and people who come on those farms, they're very emotional, and if we let that keep happening, Speaker, we let that keep happening, and we're going to be responsible. The government is going to be responsible. It's going to be on their watch if something unspeakable happens, because, quite frankly, they didn't want to spend the money or the time or do it right. I've been at this job since 2011, and I've never seen farmers in my office so emotional as specifically livestock farmers when people come onto their farms, basically, and to a family farm, the farm isn't just their workplace. Walking into my barn is the same as walking into my house, and the fact that the rest of the people who don't work on farms don't realize that, it's causing a problem. And people are going to start feeling like they have to. If they have to start feeling, Speaker, like they have to defend themselves, it's not a good thing. Especially they are saying we want to do everything we can to make this system work, but they want to be protected. And for the safety of the people who have these views, when they try to block trucks going into processing plants. We know that's happening. We need to have the resources to stop that from happening before people get hurt. We can't just ignore these issues. And this, the fact that we're talking about making changes to OSPCA, gives us a unique opportunity to actually make all the changes that need to be made. I'm reaching out. We are reaching out to the government to take this opportunity. The Minister of Agriculture, the Solicitor General, the Attorney General, and take this opportunity. Actually, listen to the farm community. Listen to everybody, not just the farm community. I want to make, and I want to reiterate this, we are not saying that people can't make their views known. That is not the point here. I respect that. One of the great things about democracy is people can have different views and make them known. Where we cross the line is when we knowingly break laws. And when people knowingly trespass on a farm, then we have to have, the government has to have the resources in place that those people can be brought to justice. Because unless that happens, it's going to happen over and over and over again. I've had people come to me that we have to make the laws stronger. There's a few things we could change in regulation, but unless you actually have enforcement behind that regulation, you can make all the, and this government doesn't like regulation much, I know, but you can make all the regulations you want, but unless you enforce the ones you have, you're wasting everybody's time. And here we don't have time to waste. We have a unique opportunity, Speaker. It's actually a good thing that we're all here talking about this on Sunday, because this, we will remember this Sunday, and we will rue this day if a year from now there's a headline that there was an altercation on a farm and someone was hurt because they didn't feel anyone in the province had listened or was protecting them. We will rue this day. We have a chance. Pass this bill, but this is just the beginning, Speaker, just the beginning. We have a chance to actually protect domestic animals, protect pets, but also protect all the people who work with animals. We have this chance to do that, Speaker. Let's all work together and let's take this chance. Thank you very much.